Hello students, this is Anthony Christie Melson, Department of Mathematics, BMS College of Engineering, bringing to you a continuation of solution of Lagrange's form of linear PDE. In this presentation, I will be discussing about the case 3 method of solving Lagrange's form of linear PDE. This method is adopted when either case 1 or case 2 fails to give a complete solution. If we recollect the auxiliary equation for Lagrange's form of linear PDE, we have dx by p equal to dy by q equal to dz by r. When the direct solution or the complete solution is not possible with these three, we introduce an alternate or equivalent form using Lagrange's multipliers p1, q1 and r1 to give p1 dx plus q1 dy plus R1 dz over PP1 plus QQ1 plus RR1. As a special case, we can have PP1 plus QQ1 plus RR1 equal to 0. In the general form, we require that this equivalent form that we have constructed using the multipliers results in an integrable form. For the special case, we need to know these identities, which is summation x power n minus y power n equal to 0. When we expand a summation in a cyclic form over x, y and z, the result will be 0. Similarly, summation x power n into y power n minus z power n will also be 0. So if we can bring PP1 plus QQ1 plus RR1 in one of these two forms by either multiplying or dividing by a certain variable, then we get a special case for case 3. As an example, I have chosen solve x squared into y cube minus z cube p plus y squared into z cube minus x cube q equal to z squared into x cube minus y cube. The auxiliary equation for this PDE will be given by equation 1. Now, as we can see, p, q and r are in cyclic form. That is, x, y and z, when we interchange in a cyclic form in one of the variables, that is in capital P for example, that will result in Q. And if we interchange X, Y, Z again in capital Q, we get R. So when we have cyclic forms for capital P, capital Q and capital R, it is possible to make use of the special case of case 3. For that, we need to make use of equation 2 to get an equivalent simultaneous equation. So we choose x, y and z as multipliers. We can make the powers of x, y and z in capital P, Q and R as same. Therefore, PP1 plus QQ1 plus RR1 will result in equation 3, which is actually 0. So if we combine this with any of the fractions in equation 1, it will result in p1 dx plus q1 dy plus r1 dz equal to 0. And hence, we get equation 4, which is in an integrable form. Therefore, integrating this will give us equation 5. So we can choose u equal to x squared plus y squared plus z squared. Now similarly, if we choose another set of multipliers for equation 1, say in this case, we eliminate x squared, y squared and z squared so that we can use the other identity. So we choose p1 as 1 by x squared, q1 as 1 by y squared and r1 as 1 by z squared. We get equation 6 to be 0. Therefore, P1 dx plus Q1 dy plus R1 dz equal to 0, which gives us equation 7. Now, equation 7 is also in the integrable form. So, integrating this, we get equation 8. So, we can choose v equal to 1 by x plus 1 by y plus 1 by z. The solution of the Lagrange's form of linear PDE is f of uv equal to 0. So, we substitute for u and v to get equation 9, which is the solution of the required PDE. As another example, I have chosen solve mz minus ny into p plus nx minus lz into q equal to ly minus mx. This is also cyclic in nature in LMN and XYZ. So the auxiliary equation is given by equation 1. Even though equation 1 is cyclic in nature, we cannot make use of the identities which we used for the previous problem. But we can make use of the special case of Lagrange's linear PDE. So what we would do is make sure that the coefficients of the variables are the same. So if we observe in capital P, coefficient of z is m, and in capital Q, coefficient of z is L. So to make that same, we choose P1 equal to L, so that PP1 will have LMZ. And if we choose Q1 as M, coefficient of Z will be minus MLZ. So they do cancel out. So the third one that is left out will be R1, which will be obviously N. So PP1 plus QQ1 plus RR1 will result in 0. Therefore, P1 dx plus Q1 dy plus R1 dz will be 0, and hence we get equation 3. L, M, N are constants, therefore equation 3 is in the integrable form. Integrating this, we get Lx plus My plus Nz equal to C1. So we can choose U equal to Lx plus My plus Nz. Now to choose another set of multipliers, now we can make the coefficients of L, M and N to be the same by choosing appropriate multipliers. So coefficient of M is Z in capital P and X minus X in capital R. So we choose P1 as X. So we get MXZ for PP1, and RR1, if I choose R1 equal to Z, we get minus MXZ. So the two terms cancel out. So we have P1 as X, R1 as Z. So the remaining Q1 will be Y. So we get PP1 plus QQ1 plus RR1 equal to 0. Which results in P1 dx plus Q1 dy plus R1 dz equal to 0, which implies x dx plus y dy plus z dz equal to 0, which is in the integrable form. Integrating, we get v equal to x squared plus y squared plus z squared. Since f of uv equal to 0 is the solution of Lagrange's form of linear PDE, we substitute u and v to obtain f of lx plus my plus nz, comma x squared plus y squared plus z squared equal to 0. So in this example, we see that capital P, capital Q and capital R are not cyclic in nature. but we cannot obtain the solution, complete solution of this PDE using case 1 or case 2. Auxiliary equation is given by equation 1. So one of the solution can be obtained using case 1, which is by choosing dy by 2xy equal to dz by 2xz, separating the variables and integrating, we get y by z equal to c1. And hence u equal to y by z. Now to get the remaining solution, that is v, we make use of the Lagrange's multipliers P1, Q1, R1. Now if we can choose P1, Q1, R1 appropriately so that we get integrable form, it would be ideal. So we choose X, Y and Z as the multipliers. The reason being, I am looking to make sure that the coefficients that we choose or the multipliers that we choose bring P1 dx plus Q1 dy plus R1 dz over PP1 plus QQ1 plus RR1 in an integrable form. So choosing X, Y and Z as multipliers will result in similar terms appearing in PP1 and QQ1 RR1. So we have second term in the denominator as xy squared, which is from PP1, and 2xy squared from QQ1, which are like terms and hence can be simplified. So simplifying this, we get equation 5, which is in the integrable form. I can combine this with any one of the ratios from the auxiliary equation. So I have chosen dy by 2xy along with equation 5. Separating the variables and rewriting, we get equation 6. Now the left hand side of equation 6, if you observe, numerator is the total derivative of the denominator. Therefore it is in the integrable form. Therefore integrating, we get log of x squared plus y squared plus z squared equal to log y plus the arbitrary constant, I will choose it as log c2 so that the log can be eliminated. So we get v equal to x squared plus y squared plus z squared, and hence the complete solution for this given PDE will be f of uv equal to 0, which is f of y by z comma x squared plus y squared plus z squared over y equal to 0. In this example, we see that capital P, capital Q and capital R can be obtained by cyclic change in one of them. But then all the signs are positive. So even though this is cyclic in nature, we cannot make use of the identities to get denominator as 0. The denominator can be brought 0 only when we have opposite signs. The auxiliary equation is given by equation 1. So we need to choose appropriate multipliers such that we can get integrable forms. So if we choose P1, Q1, R1 as 1, minus 1, 0 and 0, 1, minus 1, that will eliminate third variable. So when we choose 1, minus 1, 0, we are not considering dz, and hence, and in the denominator, z is getting eliminated. Similarly, when we have 0, 1, minus 1, x is getting eliminated. Rearranging, we have equation 3, which is in the integrable form. That is, we have df by f form for both the left-hand side and the right-hand side. Integrating, we get log of x minus y equal to log of y minus z plus log c1. So we can choose u equal to x minus y by y minus z. One can argue that we can choose one more multiplier in the form of 1, 0, minus 1. But then 1, minus 1, 0, 0, 1, minus 1, and 1, 0, minus 1 are dependent. We require u and v to be independent solutions, and hence we cannot choose 1, 0 and minus 1 as the one more set of multiplier. We need to look for alternate methods. So if we choose 1, 1 and 1 as multipliers, we get equation 6. Now if we can combine this with equation 3. So we get dx minus dy by y minus x equal to dx plus dy plus dz by 2 times x plus y plus z. So we have variable separable form and integrable form. Rearranging this, we get equation 7. And integrating, we get 2 times log of x minus y equal to minus log of x plus y plus z. So using theory of logarithms, we get equation 10 and equation 11. And hence we can choose v equal to x minus y whole squared into x plus y plus z. Therefore, the solution of the required PDE will be f of x minus y by y minus z, comma x minus y whole squared into x plus y plus z equal to 0. Another example with capital P, capital Q and capital R, which can be obtained by cyclic change. But again, identities cannot be made use of. So we have to make use of the Lagrange's multipliers to obtain equivalent simultaneous equations and hence solve. So as earlier, again we can make use of 1 minus 1 0 and 0 1 minus 1 as multipliers, which will result in equation 2, which simplifies to u equal to x minus y by y minus z. As discussed in the previous problem, if we have chosen 1 minus 1 0 and 0 1 minus 1, the third triplet cannot be 1 0 minus 1, because the 3 would become dependent and u hence will result in u and v to be dependent. If we choose x, y and z and 1, 1 and 1, we get x dx plus y dy plus z dz over x cube plus y cube plus z cube minus 3xyz. The idea here for choosing x, y and z is to ensure yz, zx and xy are in the same form by choosing to multiply with the missing variable. And 1, 1 and 1 result in the right hand side of equation 4. If we recollect the conditional identities from the earlier classes, what we see is x squared plus y squared plus z squared minus xy minus yz minus zx is a factor of x cube plus y cube plus z cube minus 3xyz. And hence we have equation 5. So we can find a common factor in the denominators of both left hand side and the right hand side, which gets cancelled. The cancellation alone does not result in integrable form, And what we observe is dx plus dy plus dz is the total derivative of x plus y plus z. So we bring that to the right hand side to form equation 6, which is now in the integrable form. Integrating this, we get equation 7, which simplifies to equation 8. So we can choose v as x plus y plus z whole squared minus x squared plus y squared plus z squared equal to minus c2. Or we can simplify this further. So we have the solution to be equation 9, or a simplified form given by equation 10. Thank you.